Not so very long ago, in the top left-hand corner of Wales, there was a railway. It wasn't a very long railway or a very important railway, but it was called the Merioneth and Llantysilly Rail Traction Company Limited, and it was all there was. And in a shed, in a siding, at the end of the railway, lived the locomotive of the Merioneth and Llantysilly Rail Traction Company Limited, which was a long name for a little engine, so his friends just called him Ivor. Now, in the morning, Jones the Steam, the engine driver, would come down over the hill. Morning, Ivor. Jumping call this morning. He would take wood and paper and light Ivor's fire. Fill up his coal box. Check the water. And then, when Ivor had steam up, he would make his pot of tea. And sit on Ivor's step to drink it. Ah, well, right then. We'd better do some work, I suppose. Out they would trundle, out of the shed and out into the bright morning air. Jumping cold it was too that morning, but bright as a pin, and Ivor felt glad to be alive and steaming, because little engines love the cold weather. Hello, the signal was against them. Oh, here's a how do you do. Owen's not awake yet. Give him a blow, Ivor.
Is it early you are, Jones the Steam?
No, it's late. You are when the signal. Pull your little lever back. We got work to do. Up the hill into Lanyog Station. There's Dye Station. Look, waiting for them.
Morning, Jones. Morning, Ivor.
Morning, Di. What have you got for us this morning?
Oh, nothing special. We'd better get some coal up for Grumbly Gasworks. There's a box of tomatoes for Mr. Davy at Tanny Gilch, and this bag of fish for Mrs. Thomas, you know, if you wouldn't mind.
Oh, I don't mind. I'll take it in with Ivor.
I wouldn't do that. She'll want it fresh, not fried.
All right, then, I'll put it on the coal.
Right away, then, Jones. Bye, Ivor.
See the trees and the stone walls and the horses and the sheep and the houses and the sea shining in the distance.
Morning, Ivor. Morning, Mr. Jones.
Morning, Mr. Pugh.
Is it coal you want, Mr. Jones?
What else have you got, Mr. Pugh?
We've only got coal, Mr. Jones.
I tell you enough coal. Station said nothing special. Mr. Davy got his tomatoes, Mrs. Thomas her fish.
Thank you, Mr. Jones.
You're welcome, Mrs. Thomas. And they reached Grumbly Gasworks and delivered the coal. Time for choir practice. Evans, the song, was waiting for them.
From the top, if you please.
Oh, didn't I tell you? Ivor is a member of the Grumbly and District Choral Society. Very proud they are of Ivor in the Choral Society. Well, there's not many choirs have a locomotive singing first base. It's not at all usual, even in Wales.